Hi gamers, as you can see, there are a lot of roguelike games released every year. So, to help you find the best, I've made this list of the best roguelike games of the year in this 2023. Just for your information, the game I'm putting on it was only released in this 2023. So, without further ado, let's get started. Bone Razor Minions stand out from the crowd as one of the best bullet hell survival games on the market. The gameplay is a highlight, featuring variety of minions with both damage focus and useful things. As a necromancer, raising your army of the dead requires strategic decisions, as each minion can take a different path to level up, making the game more complex. The game offers 16 different classes, each with its own unique attributes and playstyle. Whether you prefer raising giant minions or focusing on quantity over quality, there's a class that suits your preferred strategy. Akasilotl is an engaging top-down shooter that combines elements of roguelike gameplay with a deadly yet adorable premise. In this game, you take control of a Mexican salamander, and your objective is to find the missing food and rescue your babies. You will traverse different biomes while engaging in a gun battles with enemies like rabbit forest, dwellers, and spinning crabs. The game offers a wide variety of weapons, including the classic AK with unlimited ammo, as well as the other options like katana and automatic pistols. The game's replayability is enhanced by the countless combinations of power-ups and weapons you can experiment with. Despite starting from the beginning after each death, the desire to discover the perfect combination keeps you coming back for more. Oblivion Override is a hack-and-slash roguelike game that takes inspiration from Dead Cells, Muramasa the Demon Blade, and Castlevania. The gameplay is fast-paced with a 2D action roguelike format. The combat system has been described as rich, frenetic, and stylish, providing a satisfying fast-paced experience. The game mechanics, including wall running and dashing, enhance the fluidity and create sense of agility for the player. Oblivion Override provides players with various weapons and hundreds of perk combinations to customize their playing style and experiment with. Even though it's still in early access, Metroidvania and roguelike fans will find this game to be a fantastic choice. Voidigo is an action roguelike shooter that recently left early access and is being held as one of the best roguelike shooters since Nuclear Throne. It offers randomly generated dungeons with diverse environment, a wide range of weapons and abilities, and a balanced mix of challenging enemies. The combat system is highly regarded for its satisfying and impactful feel, incorporating both ranged and melee combat. Additionally, Voidigo includes sub-levels, challenge rooms, and shops where players can earn valuable rewards, replenish ammunition and health, and acquire game-changing abilities and weapons. The game successfully avoids overwhelming players despite its extensive content and variety. Deadling is a fast-paced first-person shooter with roguelike elements. The game combines cyberpunk style with cel-shaded graphics that create a visually appealing world. The inclusion of three elemental effects, fire, corrosion, and shock, in combat introduces a strategic layer to weapon selection, and the presence of specific weak weapons on enemies encourages players to adopt focused attacks. The progression system in Deadling is fairly standard for a roguelite. Resources acquiring during each run can be used to permanently upgrade the character status, providing an advantage for future runs. While the storytelling in Deadling doesn't particularly shine, the game compensates with excellent voice acting and arcade-heavy gameplay, make Deadling engaging, especially for shorter gaming sessions. Wild Frost is a deck-building roguelike game where evil forces corrupt everything. In the game, players attempt to stop an endless winter by recruiting randomly generated adventures and battling monsters in turn-based card battles. The game features a unique city-building twist where players build a town full of buildings that can unlock new companions, pets, and items to help on the journey. Every battle transforms into a survival game, seeking victory while avoiding the leader's death, which will end the game. Any injured allies will carry a debuff into the next encounter. It's vital to make each move perfectly calculated to achieve the desired outcome. And if you like roguelike deck builders game, you probably don't want to miss this one. XXX is a roguelike action platformer that draws heavy inspiration from the classic Mega Man X series. It is the sequel to the game 20XX and features co-op gameplay, randomly generated levels, and permadeath. Building upon its predecessor, 30XX offers an impressive graphical upgrade, multiple game modes, tight controls, and variety of creative weapons. The game has two playable characters, Nina and Ace. Nina boosts an arm-mounted blaster with unlimited ammo, while Ace relies on a melee-centric energy sword. The removal of traditional charge mechanic allows for seamless use of abilities, keeping the gameplay dynamic and engaging. Ember Knight is inspired by the popular game Hades. With its vibrant art style and multiplayer feature, it offers a fresh take on the genre. The core gameplay revolves around fluid and satisfying combat, where players engage in intense battles with various monsters using the Ember Blade. The game features three distinct levels, each with mini-bosses and a main boss, accompanied by unique enemies. Mastering your skills and the fast-paced combat mechanics allows for a wonderful flow of replayability. What sets Ember Knights apart is the co-op mode. Playing with up to 3 other people will add to the enjoyment of battling against a variety of enemies. Twenty Minutes Till Dawn is a roguelike survival game where endless hordes of creatures lurk in the darkness. The game features a variety of talents that can be unlocked and upgraded by collecting experience points dropped by defeated enemies. These talents include improved fire rate, damage, shields, and summonable allies. Players can also unlockable new characters, weapons, and runes between each run. The difficulty of the game increases with each successful run, providing a satisfying challenge for hardcore gamers. Astral Ascent is a 2D action roguelike similar to Dead Cells. The game features a variety of characters, each with their own unique abilities, aiming to defeat the 12 Zodiac Time Guardians and free the trapped animal characters. The game introduces a spell system where spells must be used in specific order. The spell's variety is impressive, and players can further enhance them with additional effects called gambits. You can upgrade various stats and unlock new abilities between runs, providing a sense of meaningful progression. If you enjoy roguelikes and fast-paced action game, Astral Ascent is a must-try. My magic is yours. Dead Must Die is an exciting roguelike RPG bullet heaven game where you play as heroes on a mission to defeat death itself. The gameplay similar to Vampire Survivors, as you know, is an action roguelike game. Each character in the game having their own playstyle and abilities. Players can make themselves formidable opponents to the guardian of each circle. However, not every character is as good as others, and each character has his own perks and limitations. Despite still being in early access, Dead Must Die shows great potential to become a favorite among survival game enthusiasts. Allow me to interfere as the guards. Wall World is a 2D mining roguelike that takes players on a sci-fi adventure, where humanity survives on an endless wall navigated by robotic spiders. The gameplay is divided into external and internal segments. In the external parts, players climb the wall in their robot spiders, searching for weak points to drill and mine resources. The external pace is not without challenges, as waves of aliens threaten the spider, escalating in difficulty as players climb higher. Once a hole is drilled into the wall, players transition to the internal pace, mining resources and upgrading their equipment. This creates an addictive loop of mining, upgrading, and racing against the time. Halls of Torment is a game that combines elements of Vampire Survivors with the iconic Diablo series. The game involves slaying hordes of monsters in the Halls of Torment. The game introduces a variety of hellish monsters that behave differently and throws them together in challenging combinations, from dodging swords of skeletons, creepy imps to dealing with slimes, hellhounds and necromancers. There's plenty of moment-to-moment puzzling and strategy to be had. If you want to do some skeleton smashing action but aren't sure about Diablo 4, this game might be worth checking out. Holocure is a fan-made game that combines elements of Vampire Survivors and the world of VTubers. The goal is to either defeat bosses in stages or survive as long as possible in an endless mode. The game rewards players who stumble upon powerful combinations, adding to the excitement. Not only that, Holocure introduces the Holo House mode, where players can decorate their own house, grow crops, feast, and cook dishes. Feasting in Holocure is more than just a simple mechanic. It incorporates a rhythm game, making it enjoyable activity in itself. Brotato is a top-down arena shooter roguelike game where you play as a potato. The gameplay revolves around surviving waves of alien attackers as you collect new weapons, characters, and items. The depth of combat in Brotato is where the game really shines. Players can wield up to 6 different weapons at once and equip items that provide buffs, debuffs, and unique abilities. Trying out different builds and skills combinations is addictive, making the gameplay consistently compelling. Riven's Watch is a cooperative roguelike action game that combines intense real-time combat with deep gameplay and replay value. Whether you play solo or team up with other players in co-op mode, Riven's Watch delivers an immersive experience that revolves around skillful combat, unique characters, and evolving challenges. The game allows you to choose from a classic characters from myths and fables. Your mission is to battle the emerging nightmares of Rivery, a world corrupted and in desperate need of saving. Although the game is still in early access, it doesn't have much to offer at the moment, but the gameplay concept is really fun even with just the content available. The Last Spell is a unique blend of Final Fantasy Tactics and They Are Billions game, offering a roguelite experience where you must defend a small settlement from hordes of monsters. Your objective is to protect the last remaining mage as they try to cast the last spell and banish all magic from the world. During the day, you'll spend resources on upgrades and building defenses, while at night you will defend your home from waves of enemies. Combine that with extensive customization and build options for each characters, and you can spend hours and hours killing the hordes of enemies. Crab Champions is a fast-paced third-person shooter game with rock-like elements. The game offers a variety of gameplay modes, including survival, racing, and duel modes. Despite being in early access, Crab Champions has shown great potential with variety of upgrades and weaponry that keep its run fresh. Many people say that Crab Champions is a Risk of Rain 2 light version. I definitely agree with that, but if you're more interested in shooting or movement and shorter runs, Crab Champions is the game that you must try. RoboQuest is a fast-paced FPS roguelike game that offers both single players and two-player co-op gameplay. The combat is incredibly fast-paced, require constant movement to survive, each level offers multiple paths to explore. The metagame leveling system seems like a great way to provide a sense of progression and allow players to enhance their abilities and loot quality as they continue playing. And of course, the wide range of guns available, ranging from pistol to rocket launchers, offers a diverse and enjoyable experience as players search for the perfect loadout for each run. Returnal is a third-person shooter game with roguelike element. The game offering players a combination of intense bullet hell action and captivating sense of exploration. The game's combat mechanics are a major highlight, featuring tight and responsive gunplay that rewards skill and strategic decision making. The variety of enemies with their unique behaviors add depth and excitement to the combat encounters, ensuring that each battle feels fresh and challenging. This aspect of the game keeps the gameplay experience exciting and encourages experimentation. Darkest Dungeon 2 is a game that challenges you to survive a perilous journey through a twisted and corrupted world. You will need to manage your resources, your heroes, and your sanity as you face Eldritch Horror and Cosmic Threats. The game retains Darkest Dungeon stylish presentations, featuring creepy characters, unsettling music, and delightful gloomy writing. The transition to 3D graphics maintains the game's signature art style, giving everything a wider presence and enhancing the visual experience. The combat system is deep and complex, requiring you to consider your hero's position, skills, stress levels, and relationships. Have a Nice Death is an innovative take on the roguelike genre, offering players the chance to take on the role that in a quirky and soulless Afterlife Corporation. The game is fast and responsive, with a diverse weapons arsenal of skills, spells, and secondary weapons to cleverly eliminate enemies. Each chapter of the game revolves around different methods of death, introducing unique enemy types and visually striking design that enhance the overall experience. Moreover, the game offers an engaging lore and incorporates bureaucratic imagery, accompanied by amusing dialogue and an intriguing storyline. At your disposal, you'll be sure to find the perfect tool to put those sorrows back. For the King 2 is shaping up to be a worthy successor to the original game. As a co-op, roguelike, tabletop turn-based RPG, it offers a unique blend of gameplay elements that create a virtual RPG board game experience. The sequel introduces new mechanics such as combat taking place on a 4x2 grid and bonus movement action for characters. These tactical strategy elements add depth to battles, making each encounter unique and engaging. The game also introduces new classes and expands on the build crafting system, allowing for more experimentation and customization. Blast Blue Entropy Effect is a great action roguelike with 2D platformers. The gameplay involves jumping into a simulation as a robot character fighting off enemies called samples to gather intelligence. The more samples you fight, the stronger you become. The game shares similarities with Dead Cells, but without the Metroidvania exploration aspect. Instead, you progress through a series of stages, broken down into smaller sections that you can choose randomly. The core gameplay is enjoyable, with a mix of action platforming and combat elements. While the game is in early access, it already looks good and I think it has a bright future. Rix of Rain Returns is a game that offers the players a chance to experience a challenging and rewarding roguelike adventure. The game now comes with an updated visual style, more detailed animations, and a redesign of the character sprites. The gameplay loop of Rix of Rain Returns follows the familiar pattern of killing enemies, opening chests, picking up items, and repeating the process until you activate the teleporter, defeat the boss, and collect the boss item. The inclusion of variety of survivors, each with their own unique playstyle, adds to the diversity of the gameplay. The game also includes some fan favorite content from Rix of Rain 2, such as items, enemies, and bosses. And that's it for today! What do you think about this list? I know that some of you might disagree with this list, so feel free to share your top best roguelike games that you think deserve a spot on the list. If you enjoy this video, please like the video and make sure subscribe if you don't want to miss another great list. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.